This Wells guy can't be far. Those must be the clocks he was talking about. Are you Wells? Your friend asked me to come looking for you.
That must be Horowitz. Glad he got out. I stayed back to help the others. Did a shit job of it, clearly.
You tried. That's enough. Horowitz needs your help now. How do we get out of here?
We should head back through the threshold. We can look for other survivors as we go.
We better hurry. Which way?
Just follow the blood.
Let's go.
What's with the clocks?
Effect. This used to be a regular office wing before the threshold manifested. The forces of claim got hold of someone's old clock and started duplicating it. Now the office is abandoned and its clocks all the way down.
you came down here for an altered item?
The ag girl, yeah. Langston said it'd be a simple item retrieval. But the power of that thing had, I've never seen anything like it.
Thanks.
That's O'Neill. Shit.
When it was clear we couldn't contain the altered item, Horowitz ordered a retreat. We got out, but Hiss was waiting for us. I took Horowitz to the motel court and went back for the others.
That was brave of you.
I'm the medic. It's my job. Almost out of the threshold. The motel court is on the other side of logistics. Horowitz should still be there. Let's go. Hold on. Something's wrong with him.
Shit.
Horowitz. Oh, God, no.
He's okay. I'm sorry about your friend.
Thanks. And thanks for coming to get me. Horowitz's HRA must have been damaged in the threshold. Guy never put himself first. At least the anchor altered item is still locked away down in the clocks. I hope it rots down there.
That altered item needs to be dealt with before it hurts anyone else. I should go back down and contain it. Head to the executive sector, Wells. They could use a medic.
Thank you, Director. I'll go see what good I can do there.
talk to the plants. Small talk was never really my strong suit. At least they can't talk back. Hope your day has been productive, little plant. That really works, huh? I hope those nasty hiss haven't been bothering you too much. I wish my leaves were as pretty as yours. Do you have a family? I have a brother. I miss him a lot. Thank you. They say I'm the director, but what does that mean? I have no experience in leadership roles. I have no on-the-job training. Your chlorophyll really brings out the green in your leaves.
That's all of them. But I kind of wish there were more. They're good listeners.
Has followed you in, right?
Shit. What now?
My old enemy, the Glock, is blocking the pipes. You need to deal with that shit. He is very clever. He's trying to sneak in. We got him caught with his hand in the fist trap. Get rid of him.
Again, Mr. Clog, you've really let yourself go. Go down there to clear out the rest of it. I sincerely hope we never meet again.
Thank you.
the altered item inside. Great. More clocks. How am I supposed to get across that? 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 Thank you.
C6 is what the Bureau calls Dylan. His cell's been breached. Has the Hiss found him? Are you there with him? Can you protect him?
Thank you.
been a long time since Dylan and I knew each other. I've wondered about him. What kind of man he'd grow up to be. Were things as hard for him as they were for me? Maybe in here, they were even harder.
Something I can help you with?
I'm Jesse, the new director. I need to get inside.
New director? Right. Well, okay. Hello, I'm Frederick Langston, the Panopticon supervisor. It's not the best time for a tour. We have hiss everywhere, numerous cell breaches, and system failures across the board, but you're the director, so here we go. Founded by Zachariah Trench, the Panopticon is our state-of-the-art repository for all altered items.
I don't have time for this.
Power and...
I was told Dylan Faden was kept here. Can you help me find him?
Faden? Sure. Darling wanted him somewhere secure and isolated, away from people. He's in the maximum security cells, upper level. But there's currently a pressing matter, ma'am. We've got an object of power loose in there. It's wrecking the place. The Benikoff TV? It's a real doozy. Salvador took a team in to handle it, but no one's heard from them for hours. This is a Category 5 OOP we're talking about, and if we don't contain it soon, it will tear the Panopticon apart. And we don't want all those altered items getting loose, ma'am. No, trust me.
Dylan's in there.
Open the door, Langston. I'll handle it.
If you say so. I usually tell first-timers not to touch anything, so, just do that. Here, I'll get the door for you. And please, ma'am, call me Fred.
Thanks, Langston.
Oh, the sudden stop hits theaters tonight. Can't believe I'm missing an Alex Casey movie for this.
Panopticon. Dylan's close. But that object of power might wreck this place before I find him. Something went wrong with... the Bureau's plan to make Dylan the next director. Marshall made it sound like it was all Dylan's fault, but how much of it was what the Bureau did to him? I don't think she's telling me everything.
At all times, or it deviates. My Schiffer blazer never showed up. Can you help me?
Damn. I can't. I'm sorry. There's an emergency. I'll come back. I promise.
Okay. Okay, just don't forget. I can't stare at this thing much longer.
That's the object of power. I need to cleanse it. Salvador, the head of security. His team didn't stand a chance against the Hiss. No one here does. Okay. TV. Another object of power going nuts. Here we go again. With the TV. Now I can find Dylan.
villain. He's so close.
Can you hear me? Jesse. Are you there, Jesse?
Emily? He's gone. Dylan isn't here. He might be nearby. Or maybe the hiss got to him. I don't know.
Jesse, listen. Dylan's here. With us. He just walked in. He says he is giving himself up. He's been affected by the hiss, but he is different than the others. We must isolate him.
I'm on my way. We need to get back. I have to see my brother.
All right, I won't take up too much of your time today, Dylan. Like I said, I want to talk about Jessie, your sister.
What about her?
I just want to get your perspective. What do you think of her? What kind of person is she? That sort of thing.
I adored my sister. When I was little, I mean, back in Ordinary.
And you don't anymore?
When I first got here, sure. I'd always hoped she'd come too. Find me, to take me home. We went everywhere together. Why should this be any different? Casper said she could come too, to the Bureau. If she wanted to. But she never did.
Why do you think that is?
Because she didn't care about me. She always wanted to be out on her own, seeing the world. She always said so. I guess she got what she wanted.
Great. So she wanted to see the world. Did she ever mention any place in particular?
Why?
We like to ask questions around here, you know that. Any particular cities, towns, landmarks, anything like that?
I don't remember.
What about family friends? Were you close with anyone living outside of Ordinary?
I'm done with this. Tell Casper I want pizza for lunch today.
Dylan, wait. We're not... End of session.
emitted from the HRAs is purely antithetical to every variant of the hiss signal I can...
No, it's happening. After all these years, Dylan is here. But am I too late?
How is he? I need to know. He's clearly been affected by the hiss, but it's different than any other manifestation we've recorded. Maybe what makes you so special is genetic. He was a prime candidate. Or maybe it's Polaris protecting him, something else affecting the situation. I need to run tests. He seems more in control, more present.
I want to see him. My brother. Or is he?
Of course. Now, Marshall set up an HRA-warded cage to contain him. It's on the upper floor, up the stairs.
Okay, I need to go.
Jesse, be careful. The resonance emitted from the HRA is purely antithetical to every variant of the hiss.
I found this token. Any idea what it does?
That is a jukebox token. Little bastards turn up in the weirdest places, like bad pennies. The Rangers use them to activate an old object of power.
A jukebox, I assume. Does it have any good songs?
Nope, just the one record. Hey, be careful turning it on, though. When it's playing, you get a free trip to the formation.
The formation? That sounds ominous. Why does it send you there?
The Bureau has been wondering that for years. I mean, it's just a pile of rocks built by God knows who, but... Well, researchers have confirmed it's in the same threshold as the quarry. Well, no one's ever been able to map a physical route to the formation for maintenance.
So it's in the quarry. You just don't know where.
Pretty much. We only send in annual expeditions to the formation now. Checkups, Salvador calls them. This year's team went in the day the hiss arrived. Come to think of it, the song should have brought back hours ago.
I can go in and take a look.
I'd appreciate that. The jukebox is kept just past the security booth over there. Just put in the token and enjoy the ride.
I have to go.
Me too. You're not the only one who's busy, you know.
Good luck out there.
This is Lynn Salvador, head of Bureau Security. I'm making a formal security order due to the incident in April, case number 21HQ593. Improper use of the jukebox altered item led to two fatalities. We believe a pair of agents used the jukebox to travel to the quarry threshold and engage in inappropriate workplace behavior. An expedition team found them decomposing at the formation's base a week later. At least we found out the jukebox doesn't bring corpses back when the song ends. I'm having the jukebox placed in a secure location in the executive sector. It should never have been accessible to low clearance staff in the first place. We need location security and proximity to a high traffic area to prevent misuse while scheduling for expedition team to access it.
I don't think I ever told you this, but I was actually on the path to being a Ranger once. Did the whole boot camp thing. Even got rookie status. Anyway, not the point. My old Ranger squad was a great bunch. There were six plus me. Remus, Hazard, Cho, Guy, Hepton, Stoll, and Thompson. They were supposed to get back from an expedition yesterday. We had beers and wings planned. Problem is, They weren't here when Darling handed out the HRAs.
Then they had nothing protecting them from the Hiss.
You see, they prepped for the worst, but I think that we're already past that. We all wore these pouches around our neck, and I really don't want the Hiss to get them. Could you find them for me? The squad would have come back through maintenance, but they probably spread out from there.
I'll keep an eye out for them, Arish. And I won't let them stay Hiss. I have to go.
Me too. You're not the only one who's busy, you know.
Marshall abandons us. I'm sick of no one telling us what's going on.
Information always been on a need-to-know basis.
Well, I need to fucking know.
What do you know about this Arish guy?
I heard some rangers saying he saved them at maintenance. They were attacked by a new kind of Hiss, and Arish got them out.
All right, but still, a security guard leading rangers? I don't know if I like taking orders from our mom. Marshall orders us to just sit on our asses and then leaves? What's the deal?
Happiness comes, white pearls, but yellow and red in the eye. Through a mirror inverted is me, right? Leave your insides by the door, push the fingers through the surface into the wet. You've always been in there, you've watched the patrol. We stand around you while you dream. You can almost hear our words, but you forget. Through time, the thunder's cold distorts you. Happiness comes, white pearls, but yellow and red in the eye. You are a worm through time.
Shit.
The thunder's home distorts you.
That's Dylan.
Comes,
can you hear me?
Red in the eye.
Oh, come on, in the Dylan. I'm here. I found you. Do you know who I am? Oh, you know me. Say it.
You are Dylan Faden's sister.
He's talking in the third person. Always a good sign. Do you know who you are?
Not Dylan. Trench and Darling made sure of that. I'm P6. P6. But I'm better now. The Hiss made me better.
Push the fingers through the surface into the wet. You've always been the new you. You want this to be true.
Can you stop that? Please. Not exactly the reunion I'd hoped for.
It feels good to say those words. I want to say them. They sound good. They make me feel good. Don't you want to say them too?
No. Fuck off, no. You need to help me get this thing out of his head. If he is still in there, if there is anything left, you have to help me.
You came in through the hole in you. We let you in. You've always been here. The only truth. A copy of a copy of a copy of a copy.
Stop it!
Orange peel.
Shit. Shit. He can see you. This is not safe.
We found Polaris together with my sister. when we were very small, in ordinary, in the desert, through the door opened up by the slide projector. But she didn't help when Trench took me away. She didn't give me any powers. All the powers are my own powers. And she didn't help when they locked me up for years.
After the song time for applause, we build you till nothing remains. The egg cracks and the truth will emerge out of you. You are home.
The Bureau brought the slide projector back here with me. And the Bureau did what the Bureau does. They used it. And they found... They opened the door up to the hiss. That's the only thing I can thank them for.
There. There it is. We stopped the altered world event in ordinary when we shut down the slide projector. And now the projector's here.
An earworm is a tune you can't stop humming in a dream. Baby, 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 yeah. Just plastic. So safe. Nothing to worry about. Funny.
I welcomed the hiss. I let it in. To get rid of her. The hiss set me free. Polaris is using you. The Bureau is using you. You are a puppet.
You can almost hear our words, but you forget.
If we shut off the slide projector, maybe that will stop the hiss.
Your regulations.
Maybe it's not too late for my brother.
You must see the truth for yourself, Jesse. Sister. The horrible truth about the Bureau. The hiss is the better option. Go to the Prime Candidate program in the containment sector. I have the keycard to get you there. Salvador wanted me to have it.
Wanted? Bullshit. I saw what the hiss did to Salvador. What it turned him into.
Okay, Dylan. I'll go. I want to see the truth for myself.
I'll go. But only to look for this light projector. You can help me. We can end this.
You are a worm through time. You are a worm through time. The thunder's soul distorts you. Happiness comes with white pearl.
I don't know what else I'm hoping to find here.
Dylan. Can we talk?
I'd like to tell you about a dream I had last night.
Off to a good start.
Okay. I'm listening.
I was back in ordinary, before all of this happened. But in the dream, I was alone. It was just me. I was the only child. A girl. My name was Jesse Dylan Faden. But then the Bureau came and caught me. Brought me back here. Lock me up. Have you ever noticed that our names, Jesse, Dylan, they could be girls' names, boys' names, could be anything. Don't you find that weird? I find that weird.
Sure.
The hell was that? Is he trying to mess with me?
You are a worm through time. The thunder's home distorts you. Happiness comes with white pearls, but yellow and red in the eye, through a mirror of the inverted.
Maybe Dylan's still in there. Maybe there's a way to reach him.
I'd like to talk to my brother, please. Dylan?
Dylan would like to tell you about a dream he had just now.
This again?
I was going to be the new director of this place. I helped you get a job here, so that we could be together. You were an office assistant. You'd make coffee and deliver the mail, and there was always plenty of work to do. And it stayed that way, forever and ever. It was nice. Really nice.
That's debatable.
But here's the strange thing. The dream shifted, and none of it was real anymore. It was a game. We were in a game, and it was a fucking boring game. But you couldn't stop playing. And then it shifted again. Or maybe it was another dream already. Or maybe I'm just confusing them. But in this other dream, it was more like a musical. This is an ordinary song about an ordinary girl from an ordinary town. It's the ordinary story. She worked an ordinary job in an ordinary office and something, 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 something. And that's all I can remember of that dream.
Maybe that's for the best.
Through time, the thunder still distorts you. How can you...
Maybe I can learn more about the hiss from him.
Can we talk?
I just had an interesting dream.
Oh, shit.
That's fascinating, but let's talk about the hiss for a change, yeah?
This dream was about the hiss.
Best I'm gonna get.
In my dream, the hiss had broken free of this prison, this house. I'd set it free. And the president himself was there to welcome us. He was the first one to take the hiss in. Spread the word. At first, many people thought it was horrifying. That he was horrifying. But also, many people who heard his words wanted to welcome the hiss in. And slowly, more and more of them came around until the whole world was brought together by the hiss. It was wonderful.
Okay, thanks for sharing that.
For the record, that will never happen. Not as long as I'm alive.
The thunder still distorts you.
Maybe I'm just here to punish myself.
Any new dreams you'd like to share, Dylan?
I'm glad you asked, sister. This dream, like all dreams now, felt very real. Like reality. And reality now feels like a dream. Maybe it's all a dream. Maybe it's all real.
Dream where my brother endlessly tells me about his dreams.
I was in a dark place. And there was a dark man there. His name was Mr. Door. And he told me that there are many worlds. Side by side, on top of each other, some inside of others. In one world, there was a writer who wrote a story about a cop. In another world, the cop was real. Dor said he himself was in all of them at the same time, endlessly shifting between them. I asked him how I could reach these worlds. I wanted to bring the hiss there. But he didn't want to help me. He didn't like the idea. What did he know?
I'm not wild about the idea myself.
Through time, the thunder still distorts.
Here we go again. Once more with feeling.
Let me guess. You want to tell me about your dream?
Yes. Yes. In fact, I'm having a dream right now.
Oh, that's new.
In this dream, I'm standing in the corner watching Jesse and Dylan talk about this very dream. This very dream, he said just now, and repeated it again now. I'm standing there and watching, and that's all I can do. It's as if I'm trapped there. And that's all I have to say about that dream.
Okay, okay, Dylan. That's good.
Is he still in there? Or is this the hiss playing mind games? I don't know.
How are you doing, Jesse? It can't be easy seeing Dylan like this.
I'm fine. What can you tell me? Is he still human?
Or is he his?
I've taken numerous tissue samples and have tests running as we speak, but from the initial data, he looks healthy. I only see corruption in a superficial way.
What does that mean?
I don't know. This is all new. But if he's like you, maybe Polaris is preventing total hiss takeover. Or maybe this is just a new form of hiss. We've already seen how it affects people in different ways.
Dylan told me he let the hiss in. Does that change anything?
Voluntary conversion. I mean, hypothetically, that could affect the mental state post-corruption, as well as the extent of biological alteration. But again, this is new territory for me. I'll need time.
You won't have it. I'm gonna shut down this lie projector. That's how the hiss are getting in. Once I close it, this should all be over.
Jesse, we don't know how this works. If you sever their connection to the source, it could cause a terminal chain reaction. Every hiss-corrupted individual, dead.
Better that than what Dylan is now.
I'm shutting it down. This has to end. Whatever happens, happens.
Okay, just let me know how I can help.
Thank you, Emily.
Jesse, when you were down in research, did you run into a Dr. Rhea Underhill?
I didn't. Who is she?
She was, is, a colleague of mine. A researcher studying a kind of extra-dimensional mold growing below research.
Well, I don't like the sound of that.
No one does. Look, I haven't heard from Rhea since the hiss arrived. Would you mind having a look around for her next time you're in research?
Of course.
Thanks, Jesse. Now, what's on your mind?
Have you learned anything about Dylan's condition?
Only that he's definitely hiss, but I guess his chanting made that pretty obvious. You know, interestingly, the words of the hiss incantation have an average length of 4 letters. The most common word, used 7 times, is want. The next most common are through and time. That's very interesting, don't you think?
I don't care about the words. What about my brother?
Right. Sorry, I got a little off track. Well, strangely, his tissue samples all look healthy, unlike the other hiss I've tested.
That's good news. Right?
I've been seeing these Darling presentations all over. Seems like he enjoys the limelight.
So you noticed, huh?
When he recruited me out of college, he actually came to visit. He interrupted my physics course by shouting, not quite, professor, and then marching down to the front of the class where he proceeded to berate the very idea of laws of thermodynamics. He's been a showboat all his life.
Darling visited you in college?
Yeah, he read a paper I'd published, came to recruit me for the bureau. I accepted and then spent years waiting for access to the confidential research that Darling promised me. And whenever I ask about my access level, he just mumbles that it's temporarily postponed and then changes the subject to the effect of entropy on luck.
I wonder who else Darling hid his work from. Marshall? Trench?
I wanted to talk to you about the crazy things I can do. My abilities. I get the sense that they're not very usual around here. Well, usual and unusual aren't really benchmarks at the Bureau, but for some perspective, Director Northmore once used the floppy disk to send a bowling ball 6 yards through the air, and that was considered a huge deal. So compared to that, you are most certainly an outlier.
An outlier. I like the sound of that.
I should get going. Don't let me hold you up.
Your eyes open, fella.
Hey, what can I do?
Oh, you're back. Oh, thank you, thank you. If I look away, I don't know what this thing will do. You have to get me out of here. The door can only be opened by the Panopticon supervisor. That's Langston, if he's still around.
Langston. Yeah, I know him. I'll go ask him how to get you out.
Please hurry. My eyes, they can't.
Hey, calm down. Just focus. What's your name?
Focus. Right. My name's Philip, and I think I can hold on for a bit. It's just my eyes hurt so much.
Just hang on, Philip.
Numerous cell breaches on every.
There's someone named Philip up in a cell. He's watching a refrigerator and very rapidly losing it.
Philip? Oh shit, I forgot about fridge duty. He's been in there for over a day, I totally forgot.
You forgot about him?
There's a lot going on. The hiss, the Benikoff TV. Considering the number of things I'm juggling, ma'am, I think it's...
Listen, it's fine. We just need to get him out of there. He said you'd be able to open the cell door.
Yeah, I can unlock it on my terminal. There. Done. Door open. But Philip can't just leave. The fridge is behaving erratically. Ocular contact is the only thing that seems to placate it. If we don't have someone in there watching it 24/7, people will die.
I'll figure something out. I'm pretty good with these things.
Being pretty good with altered items isn't standard bureau procedure, ma'am.
He doesn't know us very well.
How did you get this job?
Started as a junior agent because my uncle knew a guy. From there, I got put on a desk until an accident left the containment sector severely understaffed. At which point, I got bumped up to management. Put in a steady 8 hours a day for another 10 years, and voila, supervisor.
I just picked up a gun. Or a gun picked me.
I'll see you later, Langston.
I'll be here, like always.
Like the board, but I can't understand it. Fuck?
Jesse? The fridge is doing something!
Philip? Philip? like the board, but I can't understand it. Seems fixed. Did fighting that thing off change something?
Numerous cell breaches on every level.
How'd it go? Where's Philip?
Philip's gone. Something happened before I could get him out.
Poor Philip. He never did like fridge duty. But if you're here, then who's watching the fridge?
The fridge is fine now. I took care of it.
You don't just take care of altered items. What did you do?
I touched it and wound up in the astral plane. This thing was in there. It was huge, had one big eye. Wasn't friendly.
We've been getting reports from the astronauts lately about something fitting that description. The astral plane is usually connected to our world through objects of power, not altered items. If this thing is linking itself to altered items, then it's clearly powerful. This may happen again.
Do you think that thing is what got Philip?
Must have been. The Panopticon is a dangerous place. The agents all know the risks. But since you're some sort of altered item whisperer, I've got a list of others for you to corral. The Hiss are causing containment breaches left, right, and center. Here, start with these. I'll see if there are any others missing while you're gone. My life just got a whole lot easier.
I'll see you later, Langston.
I'll be here, like always.